You do?
I'm fine, thank you.
Please join me on the rug and we'll begin this wonderful picnic. As you can see, I've put out the club sandwiches, the roast chicken and Diet Coke. It's probably heated up there.
Yeah, it's nice and warm.
It all looks a bit pathetic, really, doesn't it?
I think it's quite good. I mean, like, I could never get the hang of picnics, but that's quite good.
Charlotte, would you care for a sandwich?
Okay, thank you. They've got a nice little bug crawling on that one there.
Yes, well, that's certainly a fresh bug. I'm not even sure what that is, but it's got wings.
It's got wings.
So, if it flies, don't eat it, is my advice to the people at home. Charlotte, a lot of people see you singing on television and just go, what an incredible voice. And listening to your albums, you have got the most amazing voice. And can I hear a note? Can I ask you to, because I'm quite a good singer myself, but I'm in retirement, I strained a larynx.
Right, yeah. Okay, I'll sing, no, hang on, let me hit.
Now, you're the world's number one selling classical singer. Charlotte, where's the big frock and the candelabra? Come on, you're getting around in a denim skirt and a singlet.
I don't know, I mean...
Or are you changing the style of classical singers?
Well, I don't think so, but I mean, just because I'm like 14 and 14-year-olds don't like wearing dresses or gowns, so...
Right. So you feel pretty unchanged by all that's happened to you?
Yeah, completely.
Oh, that's good. Now, I'm interviewing you, I'm asking you questions you've been asked a million times before, and you're doing a magnificent job of giving original, interesting answers. Do you just get sick of it sometimes?
Sometimes, yeah, but the good points really, really outweigh the bad points, so...
Right, and you just get tired of people asking the same old questions. What's the most asked question?
The most asked question is, there's a couple of them. One, how did you get your start, show business?
Haven't asked that yet.
Two, what do your friends think of your fame?
Haven't asked that.
And three, how do you balance schoolwork and singing?
Haven't asked that and won't, Charlotte. Not going to ask any of those. And which is your most hated question?
When they say, so was it your decision to do all this or was it your parents or did somebody push you into it? And it's like, do I look like I'm being pushed into this? Is it something about me or something? But a lot of people ask me that, yeah.
And you've met an incredible list of famous people. Mm-hmm. Is there anything that you can tell us that's interesting about them? Like, is President Clinton short and got a large head, or is he just normal?
No, he's got a big nose.
He's got a big nose? Oh, you don't...
It's not long. It's just really bulbous. Yeah,
really?
Yeah.
And what happens after Australia? Are you going to have a bit of a break?
No, after Australia, I go to Hawaii, then I fly to New York, then I fly back home for 2 days, then to Scandinavia, then to Brazil, then home for 3 weeks.
That is an awesome schedule, and then I believe a third album.
Hopefully, yeah. I mean, nothing's like really planned yet, but hopefully, yeah.
Great. And Charlotte Church, the self-titled album, is going well?
It is. It's doing extremely well. I think it's on 1.8 million at the moment, and that's within like 4 months, so we're very, very pleased with that.
Now, money is a core subject at the best of times, but what's it like to be a millionaire?
I don't actually think I'm a millionaire yet. It's just kind of like the British press. They said, right, before Christmas I was worth 13 million. This is what the British press said.
They valued you at 30 million?
13 million.
13.
Yeah, like my age. And then, 14 now. And then after Christmas, they put me down 6 million. So that shows what utter rubbish it is.
Yeah.
Because I must have spent 7 million over Christmas. But I mean, all my money that I do in goes into a trust for me until I'm 22, and I have £50 pocket money a month, which is about $125 a month. And you know, lots of people say to me, "Well, that's not much, you know, considering,
right.
You know." And I just say, "Well, I get all my clothes from my parents, and you know, if I want to save up for some more clothes or you know to go to a concert or something, then I will, and I just spend my money generally on." Sweets and magazines.
So just a normal 14-year-old existence.
Completely, yeah.
So if you want a Spice Girls album, you buy the album, not the band.
Yes, exactly, yeah.
The shadows fall and quickly fade away.
Denise, the picnic's going wonderfully well. We're not touching any of the food just yet because we've been too busy chin-wagging. Now, Charlotte, back to singing. What inspires you when you sing? What do you think about?
When I'm singing, I basically think about nothing. My mind goes completely blank. And that's it, and I just make like no effort and it just comes out. I just don't think about it.
So do you get into a kind of trance or a meditative form?
Yeah, kind of like that.
And is it like a nice dreamy experience? Is it a nice experience to be able to sing like that? Does it make you feel good?
Oh yeah, definitely. But it's just like you just completely block off. There's just nothing there. Mm. So you can't really like, there's nothing there, so there's nothing like of an experience about it, if you understand what I mean.
Right, yeah. It's like a void zone.
Weird, it's really weird.
Going from place to place, people probably give you a lot of gifts.
Yeah.
Do you get sick of the fluffy toys?
To be honest, I do. And I'm really sorry if I offend anybody by saying that, but it's just too many now.
Right.
It's just gone to a ridiculous thing. In Japan, I got 4. And when I was in Japan last year, I got 12. And see, Japan likes giving teddies. I mean, I still love them.
Yeah.
It gets to just a ridiculous amount. But I still love having them. But then we get home and I'm like, oh my God, where am I going to put them? There's nowhere to put them. I've got about 50 teddy bears in my room.
So you've kept them all?
Yeah, I've kept them all. I never ever throw them out.
Well, that's amazing. And so you obviously appreciate the gesture.
Oh, I do. I really, really appreciate the gesture. But my grandmother said to me, Charlotte, you're 14 now. This was like a couple of days ago. She said to me, I've told you this before, but can you please tell all these people who give you presents that you don't like teddies anymore? You like Tiffany and Cartier and all the nice expensive jewellery shops. And I went, okay, then.
There you go, Gran, up there for thinking.
Yeah, that's what my grandma
said. Now, we've spared no expense here, Charlotte. I've actually got you something. It's not a fluffy toy. It is, in fact, something to take home. It's Bill Hunter's 1,000 of Australian Facts.
That is fantastic.
Bill, of course, is one of our most famous actors here in Australia, and he's a brilliant actor too, and that's got 1,000 Aussie facts in it.
That's fantastic.
So,
thank you.
That's my pleasure indeed, and it has been a real pleasure meeting you.
Thank you, it's been lovely to meet you too, and have a nice picnic.
Yeah, have a good time in Australia.